A little cloudy today, and I think there's a threat of rain, but it's still a perfect day to work on the truck. What I want to do today is just kind of give you an update on some of the things that I've been doing behind the scenes since my last video, and kind of give you an idea where we're going to be heading next, at least for the doors. So that's what we're going to be talking about today. So let's take you in a little closer and show you some of the work I've done on the rocker panel, at least on the passenger side, and then show you some rust that I found that I wasn't expecting on top of what I've already repaired. So let's take a look. So if you recall from previous videos, this entire section on the passenger side had to be cut out all the way down to somewhere in this area over here. And I welded in a new patch panel, both in this area right here and the rocker, and all the way up to right about there. So this whole section is brand new, and I did it myself, and it was one of my first really big welding projects. Pretty happy how it turned out, and I would do this all over again. We're gonna have to do a lot more work on the driver's side rather, but I'll show you that in a moment. Now, earlier in a previous video, I showed you how I painted the firewall. I just used the same paint to do the interior portion of the rocker panel, the door jams, and all the way up to the roof. After the fact, I realized that this section here all the way down will be exposed underneath the door, so it'll have, at least for now, a nice contrast between the black that I did for this area and the dark gray that I'm going to do for the exterior. And that's going to work out nicely because I did the same paint on the windshield trim that you saw in previous videos as well. So it's going to be a black trim type of deal with a dark gray exterior. Today, while I'm out here after I film this, I'm going to paint these items the same color as the black on the outside rocker. These are just the brackets that go on the body to help hold the door in place. And really, the door just gets sandwiched in real tight with the bolts. And these are the threaded sections where those bolts go through. I'm going to paint them black just so it kind of is hidden in that area there, and it doesn't look like much. Not something you would really see, but just detail is what I'm thinking. And I'm also gonna do, this is part of the, I guess the door striker. It goes something like this. So I'm gonna paint this portion black as well, so it kind of blends in, makes it look nice. I might, you know what, on hindsight, I might do this a different color. I don't know, I have yet to decide, but I need to finish sanding these down and get them painted up, and I think they'll look nice. Let's head over to the driver's side and see what's going on there. Now, the driver's side needed a lot more work, and there's still more to do. I welded in a whole section here, and this portion here from right around here to here has been welded in. That is where the weather stripping goes. It kind of just slips on there. So I needed to put that in there as well. Still got some more cleaning up and work to do, primarily in this section, but also right in here. It's kind of hard to see, but there's a big hole there, there's a hole here, and I've been trying to figure out how I'm going to handle this. I'm thinking I might have to cut out a whole section in this area right about here so I can get in to this spot successfully, because there's no room. I got to get in there, weld in a piece, at least just close it up so it goes down, and you know, if water comes in, it's going to want to travel down instead of pulling. I'm thinking about doing that, maybe just close it off vertically and put a drain hole. I don't know. I got options, and there's a little gap there too, so that's probably a better angle. That needs to be addressed, and then I can sand all this down, do some body filler, paint it up, and make it look as good as the other side that you were just looking at. I also want to do the same thing here where I want to paint all this black, tape that off, and just get that painted and make it look nice and uniform. It's going to look really good. And the reason why I'm going with black is because I'm doing black on the inside. So this all is probably going to get painted black too. Still trying to figure that out, what I'm doing for the big areas. But a lot of the stuff that's going to get covered, I really don't see a point in painting it. I don't know. We'll see what happens. As far as the additional rust that I found, I knew this area in the back corner was suspicious, but I found that it's very flaky, and I'm going to have to do some cutting, probably cut it around here, get a big heavy gauge piece of steel, weld it in, and patch up the floor underneath, and I might even be able to get underneath the truck itself and do some work from under. I don't know. still a work in progress. I gotta wrap my head around that and see what I can do. So off camera, I started painting these items I was just talking about with this Rust-Oleum high performance enamel. So far, all I got on there is Rust-Oleum sandable primer. It's the same stuff I used on the rocker and the firewall. So sandable primer, a couple of coats, and then a couple of coats of this high performance enamel. It's good stuff, really works pretty well. Very happy with how it came out. It's honestly my painting technique that's lacking, not the paint itself. So like you can see, there's some runs, there's some high spots. I mean, all this could be corrected if I knew how to do that, but it's not something I'm gonna go through. This is just what it is, and I'm gonna leave it that way. So there we go. Anyway, what I found in the back of the passenger side of the cab was a rusty section that kind of extended all the way back here. The biggest issue I have with repairing this is I don't have the right tool. I don't own a tool that has a small enough head of whatever I'm using to cut this out. So I have a 3-inch cutoff wheel from Harbor Freight that I'll flash a picture right here of what I'm talking about. And this gives kind of access, but it really is doing a bad job at cutting this thicker steel. This is two pieces of steel that's sandwiched together on this side. And then it's rosette welded to the back. So there's actually a piece of steel that's kind of just flat up against the back wall of the cab along this area here. So I got to get that off, and I got to get some clean cuts here and weld in a new piece. Theoretically, not a big deal. I just don't have the means as of right now or the right tool to actually make those cuts in a suitable way. So that's what I'm struggling with now. I'm kind of chipping away at it here and there, but I got to come up with something. I know a plasma cutter would work so well in this situation, but I just don't have one, and I'm not going to go invest in one at this moment for something like this. So this is what I'm chipping away at, along with what you saw on the driver's side over in that corner. Now, I did promise to describe in this video what my plans are for the doors, and I'm actually thinking two sets of doors. I have a set that is going to be cannibalized for a set of half doors. So in a moment, I'm going to spin you around and show that, but I do need to track down a suitable set of replacement doors that work as just doors. So I can have a regular set of doors for the winter or cold weather, and I can have half doors for when I want to switch into something like that for just going off road or having a good time on a nice day. So the doors I have now are going to be converted to half doors. The doors I need to get, I would like to be manual everything to make taking them on and putting the new ones on, switching them out, making that a little easier. That way I don't have to deal with any electric or anything. So let's take a look at the doors I have now and kind of describe the plan that I have. What you're looking at is the driver's side door just kind of leaned up against the cab, just to show you what we're looking at. And I started removing some paint. There needs to be more work done, and yeah, so that's a work in progress as well. My plan is, if I can do this while on camera, is to cut away metal coming down this side all the way down the bottom, and then coming up, but leaving room for the original door handle and lock. So kind of swoop over and then down around those items, and that would allow me to have the original functioning door, but just a lot more open. And remove the window, get rid of this vent window here, and just use the original line of the door, come down, across, up and around, back up to the top. So the top of the door would stay to help maintain some structural integrity. At least that's what I'm thinking. Not being an engineer, just my thought. So let's close out this video with two questions that I have for you who might know more than me. First up, what tool would you recommend, besides investing in something as expensive as a plasma cutter, to get into the back of the cab there on the passenger side and make a suitable cut to weld in a piece? Or should I just weld in a piece on top of what you saw and kind of chip away all the rusty areas away as best as I can? What do you think? Patch over it as it is, or cut it out and repair it correctly with whatever tool you recommend? My other question is in terms of the half door style. This is not something I've invented. I've seen this online. A bunch of Bronco guys do it, F-150 guys like myself. They do it as well. And you know, is this a smart thing, a dumb thing, pros, cons? What do you think? Me going around the original functioning pieces of the door, is that a a good idea, or is there an easier way? Let me know your thoughts down below. In the meantime, please click the like button, share, subscribe, do all the things. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.